Grown men recognize broadcast in front of somebody.
Somebody else.
Everybody, welcome to Grown Man Record Night.
Hey,
it is a
what is going on?
Absolute freaking miracle that we are on this.
It has been quite an experience.
If you notice a difference in quality with the camera, what we're on now is probably an aesthetic that is more true to the spirit of this program. Is we're on our backup camera.
This we're going retro.
This is an old camera that cameraman is joining us this evening. Has picked up at Goodwill way back in the day. We can plug it into the wall. There's no worry about batteries going dead and all that kind of shit.
I gotta say, is it weird? Is there something in the air that cameraman actually was here tonight?
Because here's what happened, folks. The cable, the way that we connect the mixer and the camera to my computer got stripped out of whack. And
I walked in here and tripped on it.
Well, I wasn't going to say it.
I'll say it.
I've tripped a million times, but when you tripped, it actually ripped the wires out of the shit.
There's so many wires on the floor.
It was a problem, but we cameraman rolled up, and we were off the air for a while. So if you're joining us live
and
right
cameraman
now.
Cameraman said, hey, what's going on? And we said, well.
Here's some wires. Fix it.
Fix this. He said, okay, but first I need a beer.
Yeah, the fact that we're on the air, and you people that are with us live, special place in our hearts.
It's working.
Because you've stayed with us through all this, and I got a couple messages, people waiting. Really?
Go up to that nail.
Nope.
Above the skull.
All that's pulling wires down here. We're going to go off the air again.
Yeah.
The fact that we're on the air, and if you're more of a technical gentleman, maybe you will appreciate some of this behind-the-scenes footage of how we actually got on the air tonight. This is no shit. This is not a bit. We're not doing something funny.
No,
this is really how we got on the air, so check it out right now. So we're just going to narrate it. Because the audio is all screwed. Hey, Cameron, tell us what we're doing here.
So give us a play-by-play.
Recreate it.
The wires have been stripped out.
The thing got yorked and the little connector got disconnected, so we reconnected the connector.
And he called the king. And the king said, look at these.
Yeah.
What is that?
That's
some gold.
He found silver.
Bits of silver in the wiring.
Yeah, we found those bits inside.
So we're
going to
trade those in tomorrow for some food.
Put the other bit back in.
But this was a fucked situation. Capital F fucked situation.
This really was.
And we got it all to work out. Cameraman got this shit back together for us. And that's how we're on the air right now. And yes, it is with the backup camera. And I don't know why this audio is.
And Cameraman also apologized for all these bumps and bangs because I'm trying to get this microphone to hang up so I don't have to hold it.
Yeah, but this really happened, folks, and it was really a situation.
It's a really adult situation.
The fact that, we're on the air, absolute miracle of science.
Well, people kick in, you know, adrenaline kicks in.
Yeah.
Things start happening.
I go into broadcast panic mode, which I'm quite familiar with, and that reminds me.
You have a lot of experience in that area.
So it's been a little while since we've been on the show here. Let's see. You were gone. You went down. You were out of town 2 weeks ago when we did the program. And then last week, I was actually...
So when I was gone, there was quite a sequel to... last time I was here was a pretty crazy night. My dad had died, and we got pretty hammered.
Oh, we got real hammered.
Drank strawberry moonshine.
I puked. You puked hard.
But it was good, strong microphone. Strawberry moonshine.
I don't think I'm doing this right.
Something about fruited flavored moonshines. They're easy to drink, but you don't need to be drinking that much of it.
I think it's because I inevitably will grab a handful of chips or something, and that syrupy, it's like...
Sweet and salty against the sweet.
You just doesn't together. It just does not work.
But there was this possum that your cat brought in.
Cat brought in a possum.
That was quite an event. But then the next week, I wasn't here.
Right.
And there was another possum.
There was another possum in here.
Huge possum event.
Yeah.
This is like Possum House.
That's a possum house for some reason. I don't know what's going on with a possum, but enough.
Weird.
There's enough going on with the possums.
And a rabbit? Was there a rabbit?
Cat's been bringing in birds, rabbits, possums. She's a stone cold-blooded killer.
I had one. I had one just like that.
No doubt about it. She drowned a mouse in her water bowl. And not like, oh, I killed a mouse. And tonight, she's been bringing them in for the kittens. And if you guys want a Grown Man Record Night kitten, let me know and I'll ship you a kitten.
It does come with a logo on it.
I'll ship you a kitten. Because we got five in there. I got to get rid of them. I'm going to take them to the animal shelter. Yeah. Anyhow, but tonight, the cat, instead of bringing the rabbit borscht that she killed, she brought it right here in the Grown Man Record Night studio and dropped it in the floor and then laid down like, ta-da! Like she knew it was record night and she knew... And somebody,
it's Friday's time. She's bringing her share.
And somebody had told me before, cats don't bring those in because they love you and because they blah, blah, blah. They do it because they think you're a shitty hunter and you're going to die when you're like their owner.
Right,
that's
right.
Why they bring you birds and rabbits and like, here's some food. You're going to eat this, right? Because if you don't, you're going to die, and you're the one that gives me food, so...
Right.
Why don't you eat it? You know, they literally bring it because they think you're incapable of doing it.
Okay. So it's been an interesting night.
Yeah. Totally.
To say the least.
All the way around the bee. But I do have a new little segment we're going to get into tonight. Some cool stuff that we figured out this week. And check this out. Check this out. This is
what
shit.
Is that?
This is shit that happened in the news this week.
Things that happened in the news?
In the news.
Okay.
Now, the big deal this week.
What is the big deal this week?
If you ask me, anyhow, is
Donald Trump's taco salad?
That was good. Did you see the picture where they had the taco
salad? Tonight was also the premiere of Civil War.
That's true.
And my friend Jack, who has been on the show maybe once or twice,
he has.
He said that it was the greatest superhero movie he's ever seen. So
oh wow!
I'm looking forward to.
I just reread the comic, Civil War, series.
Was that the guy that drove the dune buggy?
The dune buggy comic guy?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's his name? Arm.
It was Barm.
Arm.
It was a B. There's a B somewhere.
Arm Severance.
Armb.
Arm Severance.
Oh, but I got to show you a site where you can read any comic you want. It's incredible. It's incredible. Just forever. If you're ever like, oh, I never read Flash, but I was always a Batman guy and read all the Batman comics. I think I'm going to read Flash. You click on Flash. And it's like every issue forever. But anyhow, we'll talk about that later. But what's in the news tonight, this week... Radiohead slowly started erasing their presence off of the internet.
How do you do that?
Well, people turned in. Speaking of Radiohead.
I really think you should stop smoking.
No, so Radiohead came on and started erasing their presence off of the internet. And their tweets were deleted, their Facebook posts were deleted. And their webpage, Radiohead.com, slowly the opacity was dropping a certain percentage.
Oh, really?
Every hour of the day. And everybody's like, what is going on? And so people are like, Radiohead's breaking up. And everybody's like, no, they're going to release a new album.
That's marketing right
there. And they're like, no, they're breaking up.
That's marketing.
And so after all of that, and they rebooted the website, there was a new single released called, ironically enough to me, Burn the Witch, I think it's called.
The one with the stop motion.
Yeah, it's a Queens of the Stone Age song title.
Is it?
Burn the Witch.
Burn the Witch.
Holding hands.
Strange video.
Skipping
oh, that
like
one. Yeah,
stone.
Yeah, yeah.
Burn the Witch.
There's another video out too. Daydreamers.
Directed by P.T. Anderson.
Nice. That's a good video. It's just Tom walking through buildings. It looks like one building, but it's not.
So this whole thing was, there's going to be a new album released on Monday, I believe. They leaked the single a few days before, and then there's going to be an album, I think, Sunday. So
yep. Digital album Sunday, and then you can buy in June. Right. In June, you can buy the
first. Oh, in June. You got to wait till June.
Yeah, they're going to wait.
Okay.
June 18th, I think.
First impressions, I had you check out the two tracks. What do you think about them?
I like them, and I just think if you're a Radiohead fan, it kind of just continues that wave of what you want to listen to. If you don't like Radiohead, you're going to hate it.
What a grown man band. A band that has really stayed edgy and weird and on the cuff of stuff going on, but like... still a band of grown men.
I did notice, I think there's a lot more real strings in this. I think they've brought in some musicians and added, because it sounded more robust, and I don't know that you can get that with keys, but it sounds to me like they might have brought in London Symphony or something to do some stuff, you know.
Yeah, it's, I was really impressed. I probably, maybe... I'm a sucker for this kind of marketing, obviously, with the Boards of Canada, ARG stuff. Yeah. This was very reminiscent of that. It immediately took me back to that. Why is your website disappearing? Okay, somebody go into the source code, and we're going to see who developed the software. And I'm like, all right, stop.
For months, obsessed.
But no. This was the new shit. But yeah, I'm like, nah, I'm not gonna do that this time. It was much more overt this time around.
You ever heard of a band called Radiohead?
Yeah. They came out with a Rolling Stones tribute album called Force.
Force Horse, of course.
Giddy up. But no, I was really impressed with those two tracks, and I look forward to the album release. And it really,
it's Sunday.
To me, it's inspirational as an older gentleman to know that they're...
Are they selling it on iTunes? Are they going to just put it on their website? Or?
I don't know. I don't know the deal. The last time they did a name your own price thing.
Yeah,
on,
that didn't work out so well.
Hey, I got another thing. If you follow us on the Facebook page, which you should, as well as the YouTube channel, you're going to want to check us out there. Most of you probably know about the YouTube. But if you're not friends with us on Facebook, hit that up as well.
That YouTube's the one that popped us for all out of bubblegum.
Yeah, we talked about the program.
Yeah, well, I wasn't here.
I know. We glazed over it and apologized to our European brethren. But the shit about Facebook, and if you had been our Facebook friend this week, you would have noticed a little thing that I posted about Hall & Oates.
Now, Hall & Oates?
Yeah.
Did you play Hall & Oates tonight?
I did play Hall & Oates, and that's why...
You know, John Oates was at Merle Fest last week.
Really?
Yep. John Oates, not Hall & Oates.
Yeah. I'll come back for Oates.
I think he's playing a little more Americana music. Because Merle Fest is either bluegrass or Americana. It's a good festival.
Pull up your phone and put it on speaker.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Okay. Why?
And because what you need to know tonight is there's a Hall & Oates emergency hotline.
Oh, yeah.
And if you dial this number, it takes you to the Call & Oates. Hey, Elizabeth, you may want to hear this. Cameraman may want to hear this. So there's a Hall & Oates emergency hotline. If you dial this number...
We dialed it. It
takes you to a Call & Oates service where a computer lady asks you to pick one of 8 Hall & Oates songs to listen to and plays it for you. So put this on speaker and let's call the number.
This is Call & Oates hotline.
Yeah. Okay. 719...
Oh, wait. No, I think I can just click on it here. Oh, wait. No, sorry. You're
nope.
Right.
Okay.
I got to call it.
All right.
Hold on. Our area code went to that stupid. Okay, 719.
719.
Wait.
26 Oates.
45.
719. What?
26.
26.
Oates, and that's with an E.
Fuck.
OATES.
A. T E?
E S.
S?
Okay, call that and put it on speaker.
I'll say 719-266.
No.
2837.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
No. Yes. No. I'm trying to tell people the real fucking numbers.
719-266-2837.
Everybody call it right now.
Okay.
I'm calling
you.
Listen. Oh, shit. I don't have a speaker.
Emergency call and helpline. Do you hit Please press 1 to hear it go. Please press 2 to hear Manita. Please press 3 to hear Privatize. Please press 4.
4.
You're a rich girl, and you're going too fast, cause you know it don't matter anyway.
It plays the whole song, doesn't it?
It plays the whole song.
Get it off of there. You gotta cut it for YouTube.
Get it off of there.
Slash your heart out.
So, yeah, this shit works. You can call this number and get a choice of 8 Hall & Oates songs.
8?
8. And hear them all the way through.
8?
It's fantastic.
So if you ever need your Hall & Oates fix, you call & Oates.
Yeah.
Hall & Oates.
1-719-266-28.
You said 719-26-OATS.
26 oats.
Yeah.
There you
Somebody
go.
Sent me a friend request.
Get your oats on.
I used to want to be your friend.
All right.
What else was in the news? Anything?
No, that was it.
That was it? That was all that happened?
No, that was it. There may have been more things, but we ain't got time for all that shit. What else we got?
I don't know, man. Where we play tonight?
Oh my God!
You want to go into that?
Let's do that. Let's talk about what we played.
We just didn't know if the show was going to be.
I'd already written
for a while. We were playing just listening because y'all weren't hearing it because we were off the air. Right?
I figured we were going to just be hanging out, and I'm like, oh, cool.
Let's talk about what we played. People don't even know what we played.
No,
half of it.
But I thought for a while I was like, oh, it's cool. We'll just hang out and party, whatever, man. You know. But then
that changed,
and now we're doing a show, and you're so lucky for it. You guys owe us some money. Let's be honest. You probably owe us a little money.
Self-addressed stamped envelope.
To Ross's Eggorama, Route 12, King Side Road.
Golden, Colorado.
How about some London Howlin' Wolf sessions? Eric Clapton, Steve Winwood, Bill Wyman, Charlie Watts.
Wow.
Nah, rated VG minus, but I think it's a little better than that. I think there may be a side or two that may be not as good, but... That was great.
That was that time when a lot of those blues musicians were headed to England. I think there's a Chuck Berry in London.
What's
that? This is Howlin' Wolf.
Oh, this is a... Oh, there you go.
The jar.
Get that off.
I'm not going to get up.
That's good, Steve.
What?
That beer? Tropical IPA?
Tropical IPA.
Ooh. That's really good.
It is good.
Heard that this band is playing around here recently coming up. At a soul music festival in Charlotte, I believe, Lakeside. And I pulled out Your Wish Is My Command and played two pretty slamming tracks off of this.
That's one of those bands that funky, but they'll turn on you and get really
falls off the bottom.
Sexy mellow.
I played two pretty slamming tracks, and then I let the other two play. I didn't mean to, and we eventually just got out of it. But they turned slow, but it's good shit. I mean, hell. Shit. It's good stuff, though.
Okay.
And I've not played that in a while because the slow jams turned me off.
I didn't hear that because I went to the ball game.
Oh, that's right.
I went to the ball game.
Who won?
We left in the seventh.
Fans won, Steve. That's the real answer.
They were giving up batting practice.
How about a little Aqualung, man? Not busted out Aqualung in a while. Now sitting on a park bench. I really wanted to do that.
This is my favorite Tull album by far.
I think mine too.
It's not a concept album. It's really not, according to Ian, but it's so good. I mean, when it talks about religion and some of the bullshit, and just it's really, really great.
I think when you talk about like desert rock, stoner rock type sounds, a lot of folks will mention Mountain for sure, Blue Cheer, bands like that. I think a band like this, or an album like this specifically, it's got some licks in there that I'm just like, oh, that's pretty much a Caius riff, just not tuned down so low.
Yeah.
It's got that same kind of vibe to it in a lot of places.
Yeah.
Not everywhere, but definitely.
How good is your copy?
It's okay.
Yeah.
It's okay. I know we played this not too long ago, but this Miles Davis at the Fillmore, I played a side I think I've not played before. Maybe I did, maybe I didn't, whatever. It's the one that's got some ring modulator on it. Pretty odd to hear that. Like just weird nastiness going on. How about this backup camera, folks? this is a Goodwill, just $4 or $5 phone. A camera from, what, you know what brand it is? Panasonic? Yeah, Panasonic.
Yep. Panasonic. It's an old, like a VHS 86, camera.
86, maybe?
It's an old VHS camera.
I think it's a 86 Panasonic VHS camera.
Think of the porn that was shot on that camera.
The lens.
Before you came to you, that thing was like in the bedroom.
Before it came to me. But.
That's all I'm saying.
Butts.
I don't know how we sound tonight. You know, somebody want to tell us how we sound?
Babies come from butts.
You were concerned about the level.
Uh-huh. I'm trying to project a little bit more. Not really. And I think we're up there enough to where maybe we'll have to boost mobile. Where are you at the end of it?
I don't know. I'm about here.
Yeah?
Of course, I'm not talking like that.
We got some great natural feedback. Okay.
I think I'm too loud.
Jeff Beck Wired. This was $1. Apparently I got this for a freaking buck, man.
That's awesome.
Jay pointed out Jan Hammer on drums and synthesizer.
Yeah.
Killer record. If you don't know about Wired, yeah, I don't know if
you said there was a good drum break in here. That was a good drum break.
Yeah, there's a great drum break in there. It starts out the record. It's not actually a break, it's at the first part of the record. If it's not been sampled, somebody
might be Lead Boots.
Great, great, great.
I might be thinking of Freeway Jam, which is on Blow by Blow.
Decided to pull out some Fu Manchu, some more recent Fu Manchu, 2009.
Speaking of desert rock.
Yeah, that's right, man. Stoner Immaculum, Signs of Infinite Power. I picked this up and paid a little price for it. But it's a great Fu Manchu, and we love the Fu here on the program, of course. If you don't know that,
grown man chew night.
You don't know the grown men here.
you don't know the grown men
that make up this program show.
Apparently, Joe Pye knew the grown man. He knew the grown man was doing some bad business a long time ago.
I bet Sandusky was hung too, son. I bet he was hurting some mugs up there. You know what I mean? Man.
Ah, oh, he's still alive, isn't he?
Sandusky? Yeah. In prison.
But he's still hung.
Yeah.
He's hung in prison.
He's hung in prison. He's hung in prison like that guy on that season of The Wire with a belt in the doorknob. These wire jokes do anything for you?
No.
Hey, speaking of which, I had to play this because I've been talking about that number all week, Private Eyes. We bust this out from time to time here on the program. What a great record. I loved Hall & Oates growing up because my mom really liked them, and I thought it was just really nostalgic for me, and that's why I really connected with these songs. But as I get a little bit older, I'm like, you know what? No, actually, these are some pretty well-crafted songs. And as corny as you may think they are, they hang with you and stay in your head all day long for a freaking reason.
Except for that one that we listened to that John Oates was singing.
Well, yeah.
It didn't really grab
me. Oates doesn't count.
And Daryl Hall, I mean, even Robert Fripp great. Thought Daryl Hall was a great singer and used him on that one album. That's a Robert Fripp album. He wanted Daryl Hall to sing all the songs, but the record label wouldn't let him. So he sings like two or three on the album. But
yeah, I mean, everybody knows Private Eyes. Jesus,
they're watching you.
They're watching. What the hell is this shit now?
All right, this is something I wasn't sure what I was getting into.
Is this a dig of the week?
This is a dig. I picked this up this week.
Well, I don't. I could.
This is a band. It's a garage, kind of a garage rock style band from Pittsburgh.
Okay.
Called the Cynics, and this album's called 12 Flights Up. And when I looked at it, I thought this was. I don't know who they are.
I don't either.
But to me, it looks like the way the album art is. This is like a psych record, garage rock, the same style, punky, psyche from that time of the '60s.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get up for this one, but it was actually really cool. I don't have a monitor, so I'm gonna stop right there. So it has
That's a pretty good. The label a little higher.
The album just has a
there you go.
Nice cover.
Yeah.
So I thought I was buying because the way that you know even the top where it's white and it just says stereo and you know
it does. It's got that.
But this album's from
it's 80. Got that vibe.
This is from 88.
Really?
Yeah. But it's a great record. I was really impressed. To me, it sounded. A little like 13th Floor Elevators and a little bit of that Blues Magoo sound and just, you know, pretty cool.
That's, and you know, as a kid, as a younger kid in the 80s, well, 88, I wasn't that damn young, but I wasn't hip to the skip on music either. I mean, it's funny that there was such cool stuff going on in an era that it's very quick that you can write off as being a baloney era in music.
Right.
And the 80s has a lot of crap out there.
Well, I'll
sure.
say this. There's a free concert coming up in Winston down for that. There's like a bicycle festival.
Yeah.
It's like
one
Gears.
Cracker?
And,
this one Cracker?
Well, Cracker's going to be there, but also a free concert that I want to go to is Driving and Crying is going to be playing there. And that was a band in the 80s that was regional. They didn't hit it like nationwide too much.
Yeah,
maybe one song, but it's a really good live band to see. I don't know how they are now. It's been a long, long time.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'd like to go see them and Cracker, to be honest with you.
It'd be worth it, for sure.
Especially if it's free.
Hell yeah. This was during the dark period. Now, sometime during that last record is when the dark period happened. Period. It sounds like I'm talking about somebody with a lot of iron in their blood with a dark period.
Dark period, yeah.
But what I'm actually talking about is when we were actually off the air and Steve reached over and pulled out a DJ Shadow record.
I sure did.
This is just fantastic business. This came from the girlfriend, if I remember correctly. Preemptive Strike, which I've not played this in a while. I don't know what side we played. I was freaking out at that point.
Yeah.
We didn't think we were going to be able to do anything. Look at this Goodwill camera. I'm so impressed. This is so cool that this actually works. I can't believe it. I can't believe it's not your mom's ass butter. That's all right. No. You gotta let it ride. Then you pulled this out. I forgot I got
it. I did, because you guys were like doing your shit and deep in some crap, and I was like, well. I was like, damn, this is all my fault. Let me put on Manfred Mann.
Manfred Mann's Earth Band, Solar Fire, was a dig of the week from a couple of weeks ago.
You know, I didn't know you had this. When I pulled it, I didn't even know what it was. It's Solar Fire. I didn't notice the little Earth Man. I saw a Manfred Mann played on it, and I was like, oh, this is cool. Manfred Mann's on in this prog band or something. But this is a pretty damn good album.
Dude, 49 cents at a...
49 cents?
At a Value Village.
73 on Polydor. It's called Solar Fire by Manfred Mann's Earth Band.
You know, if we were on Vinyl Junkies right now, I would be reprimanded for mentioning the price of this album.
I don't give a shit.
I'm just saying. That's what I look for in my internet communities that I belong to, is to be reprimanded often and swiftly.
Swiftly.
What's the problem?
With a Swiffer.
Whoop. That's how they do it. They start with their fingers together. Whoop. What?
It was certainly during the dark period that we put on Black Sabbath's Master of Reality. I put on that bonus disc. This is the End Is Near, what do they call it? Quality Pressings, I think.
That's now the one that's missing out of my Sabbath collection that I'm really like. I mean, there's some other things like Sabotage and... What's the one with the
with the robot that, robot on
no, the helmet, the one you really like.
The helmet?
The fighter pilot.
Never Say Die.
I don't have those and stuff like that, but in
you have Sabbath, Bloody Sabbath?
Yeah. I've got
Paranoid, of course.
Paranoid, Sabbath, Bloody
Sabbath. I don't
have
Sabbath. Any of those. I've got this one, I've got four.
Four I just I have love, got from
I love,
Jay.
I love
four. Four's probably my favorite.
This one's up there, though.
And I've got the compilation.
Sold Our Soul for Rock and Roll.
Yeah, but that's the numero uno I'm missing. And I'm,
sure is.
And just like with Volume 4, I ask myself, do I go and pick up one of the quality reissues that are out there, or do I just
wait for it?
Hang around. Now, granted, Jay just gave me the last one, which is, I don't want to say cheating, but it's...
I have a similar story like that tonight.
Yeah, it just happened. Oh, yeah?
We'll talk about it.
Okay. And one we just played before we getting on, a little VCLT from my buddy Wes. Oh, I got the train up.
VCLT. Nice.
A little VCLT from our good buddy
Wes. Is
that
a pepper? What is that?
No, it's Train.
It's a what?
Vinyl Community.
Oh, Trains.
Love Train. It's a Love Train.
From this angle on the LED LCD screen, it looks like a pepper, like a Anaheim pepper. Like that's the stem. The cloud is the stem, and the little.
You sure it's not a poblano?
Could be a poblano.
A poblano. I like. Me and the girlfriend like to hear. What's his name? Bobby Flay.
When he that guy.
When he says poblano.
Poblano.
She says his tongue is too big, so it kind of like flops out of his mouth. Poblano. Poblano. But anyhow, Beach Beat Classics Volume 3, and it's a beach. I don't know how people do this, but I'm a big fan of the Beach Beat series. And this is a compilation of North Carolina or Carolina beach
Carolina.
Music. And this one I don't have. I don't know how he just like, oh.
Hello. You didn't listen to this side, did you?
No.
Embers.
No, you listened to that last time. This is the second time we've heard it. So this is the first time we played side two.
All right, then.
But I don't know that people do that. You know, it's like
speaking of Myrtle Beach, I will give a shout out
Myrtle
to our
Beach
good
days.
Friend Taylor Vaden.
Yeah,
Taylor Vaden is a friend of ours. He's also an Elvis impersonator, and he won first
tribute artist.
He's a tribute artist. I'm a tribute artist, but he won first place in the Elvis competition at Myrtle Beach. That's a big thing.
It is.
He was in the amateur class.
Yeah,
but because pro class, I think 60% of your income has to come from...
Which is nuts.
Well, no, it's crazy.
It's cool if you can pull it off, but great,
but
whatever.
He has a real job, and he does this, but he does it really well, and he won first place. So I want to give a big shout-out to Taylor Vaden.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
And he got married
Like the week before he got married, they were in Charleston for a week.
Days before.
Before he comes back to home, he goes by Myrtle Beach and wins that damn contest. I mean, that guy must be on cloud nine.
You folks may remember this from when Metal Theologian sent me some VCLT. One of the records that he sent me was...
Elvis.
It was an Elvis talking
record. But it wasn't
him
singing.
It was him talking.
It was all the cuts between the songs.
And he was talking about...
Live talking.
Get ready for one of the worst records you've ever heard in your life. And I listened to it, and it was funny, and I was like, oh, that's funny. Then I realized that I bet Taylor would really like this record. Yeah. And it was a pretty unique and cool record, so I kind of didn't want to get rid of it in a way. But in another way, I'm like, this guy's going to... Instead of just being a kitschy record I put on the shelf, this guy's going to put it front and center because he really likes this shit. So I gave it up to him.
Cool.
My buddy Hoyle.
Cool.
Gave it to
him. I mean, no one would appreciate it more.
Absolutely.
No one.
And now he won a competition, so...
And now, I think it's because you gave him that record.
It proves...
He was able to listen to the record, and then he made his act better.
It just proves that it's always pays off to be a nice guy, Steve.
Well, I'll say one more thing about...
Okay.
New to the show is the hat you're wearing.
Oh, yeah. Talk about the ball cap.
I brought a ball cap for you. This was at Mom and Dad's. I brought a lot of effects home. But one thing I brought...
Like a ring modulator.
It doesn't remind me of Dad, but this was Dad's. This is a Cubs hat, and I know you're a Cubs fan.
I am a Cubs fan and a Bud man.
And this is a Cubs hat, but it's a green. It's it's got a little...
Shamrock
on it right there. So I knew you're a Notre Dame fan too, so I thought it would go hand in hand, like Notre Dame and Cubs.
That's pretty awesome.
You were saying something about this being a hat they would...
I do remember. This almost looks like a nicer, because this is a New Era hat.
Sure.
So it's a little bitter.
So it wouldn't be like a promotional level hat.
This is a
better promotional
build quality from a promotional item that it'll give away. Although, that I have a Cubs toboggan with Pepsi on the back that did come from Wrigley, mm-hmm. and it's tremendous shape. Build quality. What, this guy?
Yeah, goddammit. Yes, please.
So, yeah, that's incredibly awesome. That may become my go-to hat.
Cool.
Ball cap. That covers a lot of bases.
Sure does.
Notre Dame, Irish, Cubs, all
right,
in one
What's all this then?
Oh, it's great.
Some fruit. I don't know how...
A little frozen.
Fruity.
Try it.
Yeah, we also
Okay. Does that mean we're going to do a dig of the week? Hey, would somebody give me my records in there? I've not even sorted them because I didn't think we're going to have an effing show.
Does that mean I can go pee?
Sit down and tell us a story, cameraman.
What story?
Tell us a story. Steve's going to go pee.
Interviewing.
Distilled water.
They are.
I got got a few things to say about the still water.
Okay.
I want to hear what he says about the still water.
No,
make stuff out of it.
Forget all that. Give us a quick layman's term breakdown on what happened with the cable this evening.
It broke.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I mean, when we really get down to it, I'll appreciate you.
Hey, girlfriend, would you grab me my beer I accidentally left over there?
I can play the game.
I might need another one, actually. I think it's kind of low.
Okay. I'm record,
sure would appreciate
that. Got a record
that.
Here I'm going to talk about.
It's got a white cover.
You call that a profile jacket in the business.
Oh, it's got a name
on
the front.
No, 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 you hold it up.
It's got a name on the front.
Yeah, they're going to guess it. They're going to guess
it.
Oh,
it's got a sticker.
They're prolific at that guessing game.
This one refers to something people use every day, and this one is by a guy with a common name from
nothing you probably know.
First name of Joey, I'll say that. His first name's Joey.
Okay.
I think I can say that based on what I saw.
Okay. I don't have a whole lot.
You just put those in a specific order.
I did. But here's a weird thing I did. Now, the thank you. 2 weeks ago,
weeks ago,
Jay and myself did the program, and we did a classic throwback like Dig of the Week, where it's not, you know, Dig of the Week wasn't originally, and you know, you were here when we did the show originally. It wasn't necessarily supposed to be about what record you bought this week. That was very encompassing, and it could be a part of it. But it could also be like, oh, this week, let's talk about weed records or whatever.
I dug this.
So we pull out.
It was just about straight what you dug.
That week, yeah.
Yeah.
What you thinking about. And I was like, man, I started thinking about all the records that had to do with fried chicken. And I pulled out, you know, or whatever. And that was kind of what we started.
I wish that had been one of the things I'd thought about.
Fried chicken's a great song.
There are some Kentucky Fried Chicken
albums
out there.
But anyhow. So we did one of those where we talked about
Kentucky Fried Chicken albums.
Last week what
That's
we talked
true,
about.
Though. That's totally true.
Last time when Jay and I were here, we did the what I call the Grown Men Record Night Sleepers. It was bands that maybe not everybody knows about.
Okay.
You love and you picked them up and you're like, oh my God. But Joe Blow may not know this band. So that was what we did for our deal. And it was fun. And it was also a way of like, I'm not buying records this week kind of thing. Because I knew I was on call the following week, which I also didn't buy any records.
You don't enjoy that
or
very
video
much.
Games.
You don't enjoy that very much.
So I went 2 whole weeks without spending money in stores.
You don't even do the show when you're on call, do you?
No, not at all. Because
hey, Steve. Oh, Steve.
Yes, sir.
You want that?
No, just leave it there. I'll be right back.
Because you could say, oh, well, do you have to have alcohol to have a good time?
I do. No, I don't. I don't have to have it, but it makes it a lot more fun.
To get on a camera and do it?
I kind of
want some alcohol.
I kind of want some of that, too.
So, you know. Well, hey, how about the build quality of this Goodwill camera?
I think it looks great.
How much was this?
Hold on.
$5?
I'll look.
You think the price tag's still on there?
It might be. Probably is. They stick pretty good. It was $10.
$10, okay.
There's two stuck to the right side of it, or the stage right side, I should say, because it's the left side if you're from behind the camera. There's probably 4 more on the other side. That's the way they do things at Goodwill.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
They put a bunch of stickers on things.
They love putting stickers on things.
That's what happens when you get people in there that really want a job and are also...
So my point was, I didn't buy records for that week.
Mm-hmm.
Me and Jay did the thing. And then I was on call, so I didn't buy anything because I didn't care.
Who did you call?
So in this week, it's supposed to be the, like, all right, I'm back on the horse. I'm going to the record store. Maybe I'll shell out $40. Maybe I'll shell out $50. Maybe if I see something I really like, I buy a big ticket item. I actually spent... $1.75 all week and got 3 records.
Yeah.
And it's just kind of how it played out this week. I didn't get a chance to really go into record store. But I did.
How do you feel about the ones you got?
The ones I got, I'm still pretty cool with. And it's, I think
this one has a cougar ripping something apart on the cover.
Oh,
a smaller picture of a cougar ripping something apart.
Not to give away anything.
I didn't give away much. If you can figure it out from what I just said, then kudos. But
that, I'm telling you, they're prolific on that mess.
Did you just say kudos?
I did. I know. I think that might be the first time I ever used that in like conversation.
Okay.
I've heard it plenty, and I may have said it once or twice, but never like on purpose in conversation. I'm pretty sure that's the first time.
All right. Well, so we can you want to talk about it? We'll talk about it.
Let's talk about that.
Where'd Steve go?
I want to hear all about it.
Okay.
Are you guys done talking?
Yeah, Steve wants his chair back. I don't know nothing about
this.
I
was just going to jump in Dig of the Week here.
Steve knows more about records. I could just sit here and talk about the cougar and ripping something apart.
Are there enough shop
us? I don't, probably not. Not clean. There, I got one here, but it's probably 2 weeks dirty.
Pass me your dirty little bitch.
Pass me your dirty little bitch.
Yeah,
so, Steve, you want me to do mine real quick?
I don't care. It don't matter.
Because you got some real shit. I mean, I got some good stuff, too.
It don't matter. Let me do a few.
Go ahead.
I did have it happen to, I got a chance to go by the Shepherd Center. They have a book.
All the books.
Shepherd Center has a book sale. It's Shepherd Center's set up for elderly to do things for them, help them have a life because there's not much for them to do.
Yeah, except
die. But they sell this. They have this huge book sale at the Coliseum Annex building. Rooms full of books, but it's also got LPs. Mostly Mantovani, mostly classical.
Sure.
I will tell you, if you want to upgrade your classical collection, that's the place to go.
They had sealed
vinyl. They had boxes that were sealed. They had really good stuff. I don't know about the Columbia or whether it was, you know, the right label, and that's important too. But they had a lot of good stuff. Huh. But I went there when I got there. Usually there's a bunch of pickers already there and digging, and you know they pick it clean. Yeah. There was nobody at the vinyl, and I was like, oh, this is great. This is the critical moment. I must choose where to start. And so I started in this one area, and I was looking. It was mostly classical. And there's a guy that set all it up. And he organized it.
They had a guy.
And he was there, and he had one of those boxes where he talks like this.
Oh yeah.
And I didn't know at the time he was the guy, but I quickly learned because he goes over to this other guy who was looking at CDs.
Now there's two guys.
He was looking at this other guy, and he's like, hey, if you're looking for some good jazz on LPs, I've got them right over here. And he takes him to the box that I was looking for. And the guy digs through, and I go around to stand next to him to kind of dig, and I'll get to this box next, hopefully. And I notice he's pulling out Brubeck.
Okay.
And he's pulling out, what's our man?
Cannonball
Adderley. Yeah. And a couple other, and I was like, oh, he basically got it. But I got a few things.
Cool.
Just for shits and grins. This one's really interesting. I did get a sealed LP. It's actually recorded in Winston-Salem. It's this organ or something. I haven't listened to it. I haven't even popped it yet. They found this organ somewhere in Italy, I think, or in Europe somewhere.
Yeah.
And they thought it was really cool, so the Reynolds Company, R.J. Reynolds, they brought this organ to Winston-Salem, and then they recorded it.
Really?
It's called the Winston Bandwagon.
Wow.
A unique collection of band organ music.
That's weird. And it's sealed.
Why did they ban it, Steve? They have a bunch of cuss words on it or something?
No, band, not band.
Like band as in they couldn't play it.
Like band on the run. So I haven't listened to it yet. But it says it's really cool. It's 1974, R.J. Reynolds Tobacco Company, Winston-Salem is the copyright.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
And it says, recorded Winston-Salem by Long Engineering. We know the Long family is Reynolds.
Jerry Long.
With a four-channel TIAC 3340S stereo recorder with Dolby processor, Deltronics custom mixers, and 8 transistorized microphones.
Wow.
I like the sound of that.
That sounds great, doesn't it?
I also got a couple of pop albums, kind of pop, rock, whatever.
Yeah.
I didn't know that I had it. I went and got it. It's a Rumors album, but it's a lot noisier than I wanted it to be.
Oh, really?
But it's got a nice original shrink wrap, so I might just swap the records that I have, and I don't need to come up and show you Rumors, but... And these records were 50 cents a piece, by the way. Genesis Abacab. Didn't have it. It's where it all turned for me.
Yeah.
But it is a good record.
It's not a bad record. It starts getting into the this is a good pop record.
This is Phil Collins.
It's in great shape and it's 50 cents.
Oh, I would eat that up.
So there you go.
With a biscuit.
Even better though, these two albums I really was happy to pick. I love Cha Cha Records. I love picking up like Cha Cha music. Here's one called Let's Cha Cha.
You have a silver cup.
With Tito Murano. What is this?
The
Burnett's. Burnett's, what, watermelon?
Watermelon.
Football melon.
This vodka?
It is.
Okay, thank you. I need to clarify all this.
Marlboro.
That's pretty good.
That's actually pretty awesome.
Yeah, can you show that? Little... So pick up this is actually a really good shake.
I gotta catch this.
Cha cha cha. So everybody likes a good cha cha record.
Oh yeah, they're all good.
And they usually sell pretty well.
Yeah.
When you check the prices on some, yeah, that's perfect. Actually, you're good. One more I'll talk about. Is Lorenzo Almeida, and I have him. I've got that one. What is it called? I forgot. Jesus. Anyway.
Joyas del Paso.
Ace of Spades.
But this is Lorenzo Almeida guitar from Ipanema.
La Numero Dos.
Brazilian guitarist. And it's a really good record. The autofocus is working well. You could be back about 6 inches probably from where you were. Yeah, man.
Cool. Check this out. Like I said, I meant to spend a bunch of money and did a bunch of records, even though I don't have space for them this week, but I hit up a bunch of like Goodwills and Salvation Armies and came up with three records in my travels this week. Let's see. Two were a dollar. No. All of these were 49 cents.
Really?
No, one was 75 cents.
Okay.
A 75er and 249s. So this first one I picked up at a Salvation Army.
You showing the bargain bucket bin graphic?
I should.
You really should. I mean, that's totally bargain bucket.
This is about a bargain bucket as you can get. Plus the shit you talked about, too.
Well, it's fixing to get out of there, to be honest with you.
Well, it's all right. So Propaganda Machinery. You ever heard of this?
Mm-mm.
Okay.
What do you know about it?
What I just found out about it, actually. This is the third single from the German new wave synth pop band Propaganda, released in 85. Song is taken from their debut album, The Secret Wish.
Is this like Kraftwerk or something?
That's what kind of reminded me of some Kraftwerk-y type stuff. More about that lately.
Mm-hmm.
The song reached number top 10 in various countries across Europe, including France and Italy, but was most successful in Spain, where it peaked at number one. U.S., the song reached the top 10 in the dance chart. And I pulled out, this is a single and it's got a couple of different tracks on it. I pulled it out and listened to a little sample and I heard a little kind of a Kraftwerk-y type line going on there. And I was like, oh, cool, it's worth 49 cents already. So, I don't know, we'll see. They had another, and if you look at that on the back. It doesn't say Made in England there, Steve, up at the top.
Yeah.
But,
I can't really tell where I'm at.
This is a UK press of this German band. But I'm interested to check it out. It seemed pretty neat, especially for 49 cents.
I'm very interested to check it out.
My 75, I got to do this one first. My 75 cent purchase of the week.
75 cent purchase of the week.
Is
How's that pizza?
Pizza pie?
Is that good pizza?
Yeah, it's got some
crunchy stuff in it.
Look at what I found. It's got profile. This is in a... This
like
is,
bones?
This is my...
cartilage.
Vegetable.
You can work with cartilage.
There's a host talking over here, everybody. I'm hosting a program, and everybody else is talking. Let's everybody take a laugh.
Somebody needs a tampon.
God. So this is my, I'm attributing this to the war of attrition.
The war of attrition.
Why you cycle through your Goodwills, your Salvation Armies, on the regular.
Right.
And whether you go in there,
here
it's
today,
all
gone tomorrow.
Lawrence Welk, and it's all Christmas albums, and it's all baloney. You keep cycling through. And I only found this one record, and it's not like a grail for me or anything. But check this out. It's the Planet Rock single from Afrika Bambaataa and the Soul Sonic Force.
Really?
On the Baby Blue Tommy Boy label from 82. And it's one of the first...
You know, when you showed me that.
What?
You sent me that picture.
I
thought it was something from the movie Tommy Boy.
Oh, I see.
Because I figured you'd be real excited about that.
This is
I had no idea. Afrika Bambaataa.
It's one of the most influential songs in
sure.
history.
I bet. I bet Mike Leitch was like shitting his bricks.
And for a hip hop single. Look at that.
Oh wow.
There's some fingerprints I saw.
Yeah.
You
can probably have somebody arrested for those prints.
No. I saw them in the store and it was like, but you see a hip-hop single like this in a Goodwill, usually it looks like somebody tried to make love with a screwdriver.
You know what the best way to get the fingerprints out is?
A fingerprint?
A little bit of 120 grit sandpaper.
If you take
you
that,
will not see those fingerprints.
off mark with mustard.
Yeah, go. You got to go against the grain, too.
And then go against it.
Mm-hmm.
That's the way to do it. 75 cents. Can't wait. We're going to bust that out shortly. And I had another single. This is one of those albums that was very seminal for me.
Hmm.
Have anything to do with a seminal vesicle?
Actually, it's down there. I've got a cassette of this song from when growing up, and it was my favorite song for a short time. And the song I'm talking about is "Believe It or Not."
Really?
Walking on Air.
Mike Post.
Really?
Who did
Hill Street Blues?
Files.
Hill Street Blues.
Wait, is that the theme song to Greatest American Hero?
It is.
Marky Post.
Marky Post. From Night Court?
Yeah.
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 Oh,
so,
yeah.
Nah. But it's sang by Joey Scarberry.
Joey Scarberry, man. Where is he now?
Don't listen to anything he says now because it's fucking awful.
You talking about one-hit wonder. This kind of defines.
Believe it or not, I'm walking.
And right down there.
Is that Greatest American Hero?
Yeah.
Okay.
Which we have right over here to watch.
I bet you do.
Yeah, so look right there.
Oh. There it is.
There it is.
There it is.
And I'm so stoked to have picked this up. I literally wore this when I'm like 4 or 5 years old. My dad had like recorded it off of the radio or something.
Your dad's out in the van drinking, listening to Ronnie Montrose.
Yeah.
And you're inside.
I got the fire!
he's like, I'm gonna finish this pint and then I'm gonna go inside.
I wonder why my dad just kicked the door in. I got the fire! And I'm like, yeah, rockin' dad's home. Womp, bomp, bomp.
I love you, Dad. I love you, Dad.
You're so hip.
Shut up!
You're so hip and drunk. but yeah, man, check this up, because I damn
Dad, why do you have so much ham?
I wore it out on a cassette. Like, it won't even play. It's down there in that bag. There's a blue old Memorex cassette from the 70s of this song that when I was a little kid, wore it out to where it couldn't play. Continue, please.
I don't want to eat any more ham.
You're buying ham on our money with our money price?
All right. This one, I had to pick up. I still haven't listened to it. I never will, probably. But we have an album cover down here.
Oh, my mic did fall. Somebody said I sound like I'm off mic.
Shit, you're off mic.
Damn.
So anyway, we have, if you look on the, I don't know if you can see it. Can you see it on the show?
Yeah.
What can we see?
Can we see the album cover in the middle on the set?
Yeah, we can.
Okay. But that's not not the right one I was hoping to get when I picked it up. Because that's the U.S. release of Gigi.
Gigi.
If you know what we're talking about, it's Umaguma. The British version has the Gigi album sitting there next to the band on the chair, or one of the members of the band on the chair. But that's the U.S. version. This is the one I was hoping to get, and I picked it up. They had it there. This is obviously the British
version. Oh, this is another, this is the 50 Cent guy.
This is the one you actually see on Umaguma.
And it's a UK press.
And it's a 50 Center.
At the 50 Cent book sale, they had the UK press of this?
Yeah.
Weird.
I think so. And it's one of those unbreakables. Unbreakable. Microgroove Unbreakable.
Nice.
So I was really glad to pick that up, and I don't think I'll leave that one here. Maybe I'll just leave
that
one.
Nah, you know.
Because that one's just the cover. This is the actual record.
Yeah, I wouldn't do that. I'll mess it up.
Last but not least, so those were all my, at the book sale, cheap 50 centers.
Yeah.
You know, I could have spent more money and got, because they're 50 cents. But
sure.
I wish I'd sent you those pictures of the Crosby, Stills, Nash record. But
oh, yeah.
I picked up a CSN, I think it's their first album. It's not Deja Vu. It's the one where they're all sitting outside on the porch, on the couch and chair or whatever. And I was like, well, maybe I'll buy this. I don't think I might have it. I don't think I have it. It was 50 cents, whatever. So I pick it out. I was like, well, let me check the vinyl quality. So I went to, it's a gatefold, and I went to open it up. And I opened it up, and in the middle are a bunch of stems and seeds and a little bit of paper from a roach that I guess had been emptied or something. It's all in the middle of this, the gatefold of this record. I was like,
here's the funny thing.
Dang.
You sent me that. I was working. I was doing something crazy. I pulled it out. I looked at it, and I'm like, oh, great. Steve found a Crosby, Stills, Nash, you know? Crosby, Stills, Nash?
Yes, at CSN.
Yeah. And I was like, okay. He's like, you never know what you'll find. And I'm like, a Crosby, Stills, Nash record. Good for you, Steve. Awesome. And it wasn't until like 2 to 3 days later we text about something else. And I looked down and I clicked on that picture. And I'm like, then I did the old pinch zoom in. And I'm like, oh, there's seeds and stems all over this. I'm thinking, he's like, I went over here and I found a Crosby, Stills, Nash record. It was only 50 cents. And I'm like, I mean, I'm not saying I wouldn't have bought it for 50 cents.
No, that's not something you send out. Like, you won't believe what I found in the book.
No, that's what I wasn't getting. That's why I didn't even say anything. I'm like, oh.
So on the way home the other day, I went by a local record store.
Yeah.
And was looking at their stuff. And they had a really nice Coltrane record I was telling you about.
Yeah, should have got that.
But he did have this, and this is a grail for me. This is the Heroes album by David Bowie, RCA, Victor, not the Ryko disc. This is the, I guess, the UK RCA Victor album. And I was really, really, really excited. I mean, it's pricey, honestly. But the price I got, it's less than what I'm seeing on Discogs. I'll tell you that. I'm not going to talk about prices.
You get kicked off.
I'll get flagged, man. So, but this part of the Berlin Trilogy, this 1977, I believe.
Drugs.
And just amazing.
And drugs.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Brian Eno.
Drugs.
Viscotti, Tony Viscotti.
Tony Maselli.
No, Tony Maselli.
Angela Bauer and Drugs.
Yes. Great album. Great, great album. And it's, I just love it. I love it. I'm really glad to pick it up.
That's pretty cool, man. I mean, that's a
Robert Fripp plays on a couple songs. He plays on Heroes. He's got that. That's like three, I think he played about three guitar parts on it.
How much would it surprise you to know that earlier today, I went into a Walmart to do some shopping. And I looked around for a little while. It was one of the Walmarts that had a McDonald's in it.
Sure.
I bought some McDonald's.
Not a McDonald's?
Yeah, I bought a McDonald's food, and I went out into the parking lot, and I used my cellular phone to play a Who's the Boss episode, and I ate my McDonald's and watched my Who's the Boss in a Walmart parking lot today.
Nice.
It was the one where Tony's on the beefcake calendar posing.
I'm real disappointed right now on MeTV, you know, Chips, every afternoon at like 4 or 3 or something. But right now they're in that season where the other guy's gone.
Bobby and...
what other guy?
Well, there's Ponch, and then there's the other guy. And
when John...
No, leaves. Steve, seriously, come on.
Larry Wilcox.
John... Well, Larry Wilcox leaves the show, and there's this hunkier guy.
What's his name in the show?
It's not John, as good, but it's John funny Lee. Because the writers... I don't give a shit. The writers are stretching, so all the episodes are really... effed when it comes to what they're doing. They're trying to stop a guy from using a laser to destroy LA.
Did you see that?
The van.
I just sent Ron this. Remember me telling you about that?
I remember that from when it aired.
Did you catch that?
There's another one with a missile or something. There's this like rescue squad that's like CIA or something.
They're trained.
So half the episode's just them doing that.
I'm a member of so many squads, I can't even get into it right now. All right. Is that all you got for Dig of the Week?
That's it.
Oh, I'm losing my voice.
I mean, I got Heroes.
You did?
That's up there for me. I got to say.
That's what I would say about that album, except it says song. But
I mean, I got Low from our good friend John.
Yeah.
Which is up there? Up in one of the highest grails on my list, you know, and it blows my mind. But to have Heroes now is, and I'm sure it's going to come out. It's not. We looked like while I was there talking to the guy, and I talked him down a little bit on price. We looked and tried to find out what might be coming out next, because you know the first five albums came out in pinups, and I think I bought Hunky Dory of all those. I'd like to get Ziggy.
I've got Hunky Dory's cover, but I don't have the damn record.
Jonathan has Ziggy, the Rise and Fall of Ziggy Stardust and Spider.
The reissue?
He has that reissue that has like two or three CDs of these alternate takes of the whole album.
Wow.
That would be, that's like $45 for. But it's an amazing thing to pick up if you're really into, and that's one of my favorite Bowie albums.
Yeah.
So.
I need to look.
But anyway, what I was saying was, we looked ahead to see what's coming out next, and it's not, you would think it's the Berlin Trilogy. I think they're holding that out. They're putting out changes.
Yeah.
They're reissuing changes, and I'm like, it's a great album, but it's a compilation. You know, stick to the core releases, I think.
Yeah, that's probably the easiest to find, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen more changes than I have anything. It's changes a great record. One. It's one of my favorites. So anyhow, let's take a quick break, and we'll come back with a Soda Speak and Chip Chat. We're lucky to be on the damn air, but now we're rolling and smoking, baby. So we appreciate you hanging with us here on the Grown Man Record Night
program. We are not smoking.
I'm losing my voice. So we'll see you here in a few minutes here on Grown Man Record. So just stay tuned.
There's a secret.
Where's the secret?
The secret's at your fingertips. It's Arthur Treacher's Fish and Chips.
How do we make the meal you can't make at home? What makes our fish fillets so crunchy? Are chips like french fries outside and baked inside?
We'll never tell.
There's a secret here tonight. Real good secret here tonight. Clap your hands and smack your lips for Arthur Treacher's original fish and chips.
So are you guys getting hungry?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Do you ever worry that they're playing too much Nintendo?
Oh, not anymore. See, Matt has Bible adventures. They're actually learning Bible stories while they're playing Nintendo.
Quick, get that Bible quote before you run out of power.
Bible Adventures features three games in one cartridge. Noah's Ark, Save Baby Moses, and David and Goliath. A must for every family with Nintendo. Call 1-800-77-BIBLE. That's 1-800-77-BIBLE.
On the next Matlock, one woman's frightening past drove her to an institution. Now she's leaving the sanitarium.
Is anybody there?
To seek asylum with her family.
Well, that's good.
They want to rob her of her dollars.
Money is not an issue here.
And her senses. Now she's accused of murder.
I don't think she killed me.
It's Bedlam on the next Matlock.
Thursday afternoon at 4 on your hometown station.
豆が二つ、おむすび一つ、あっという間に星のカービィ、なんでも吸い込む。星のカービィ、カービィ。
吸い込みぶっつけ攻撃、ぷかぷか空飛びの術、かわいいやんちゃポーズ、星のカービィ、ゲームボーイで新発売。
Kelly Blanchard, Arn Anderson, James J. Dillon, Ric Flair, The Four Horsemen. The most powerful name in professional wrestling. Their strength is legendary. Their stamina is boundless. Their endurance is beyond the ordinary. And you are about to discover their most powerful secret. This is the Four Horsemen top performance system of caplets and chewable wafers, formulated especially for the Four Horsemen.
During this period, the Horsemen were so hot, Jimmy Crockett thought he could just put our name or likeness on anything and it would sell, and he came out with a Horseman vitamin.
All right, folks, welcome back to Grown Man Record Night. We got a couple more minutes we're going to spend with you here on this Friday evening. Ba-ba-ba, ba-ba-ba. And then, I'm the chicken you're going to eat on Sunday with your mama.
And then we're going to play Heroes.
Mother's Day.
What's that?
We're going to play the Heroes album.
Oh, yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, stay tuned.
Of course, I'm worried that now I'm thinking, like, is my needle good enough? And Steve's got a good pricey record?
Nah,
my needle should be good.
Your needles are good. You changed them not too long ago.
Yeah, it's good. Only been about 3 years.
They're good. Another good needles. They're good 2 needles. Years. So let's talk about So To Speak. What do we got coming this evening?
Well, first I want to say, a while back, yeah. I did a review on a video review.
It was a video
of a local energy drink called Sunshine.
Okay.
Buck O'Haron's Legendary Sunshine. It's a ginger-ish energy drink. It was good. It's really good. I like it. You probably don't see it in your local market.
Yeah, they're pretty sparse.
They sell at Lowe's Foods here. That's fine. But I just noticed today when I was getting my growler filled that they've come out with a couple of flavored, flavors of their Sunshine. So what we have here is a clementine twist and a blueberry lemonade.
Now, ooh, I like the sound of the blueberry lemonade.
Let's try that.
You want to try it and
do a soda?
Sure. Right. Whatever you want to do, man.
So let's try one of these.
It's your world. I'm just living in it.
I also agree. I want to do the blueberry lemonade.
Steve agrees with cameraman.
Good.
It's got 100% organic caffeine, by the way. Organic caffeine.
I don't know what that means. It sounds like pussy.
They're making up a bunch of
shit. There is scientifically not anything that is caffeine that is not organic.
Of course. They're just throwing words at you.
And this is not crazy with caffeine, the Sunshine stuff.
According to them on the label, it says just enough caffeine.
I hope I'm up till 4 a.m.
It tastes artificially sweet, but it's got cane sugar in it.
It's good. I like that. You know what I figured out that I really like? Unsweetened tea.
I like unsweetened tea.
It's great.
I kind of do too.
Try it.
It's great.
What did you spray in here?
What just happened?
Someone has sprayed something really strong.
What's that about?
That bucket shit travels. Like, I forget every time.
What is that?
What is it?
Febreze. I was preemptively Febreze
is in the air.
Febreze for narcoleptics?
Drink tastes like Febreze.
That does taste artificial.
I think that's the Febreze.
In some way. No, it's not. It's the drink. What's in there?
You are 1,000% not getting this back.
Oh, yes.
Whoa.
Yeah, no, you are, but you have to help me find one.
It's still okay. Don't touch
help
it.
Me find
it's
one.
A classic.
Amazing.
The camera got couchured.
What?
Look at how much couchured room you got over there.
I got
there.
A lot of room.
I'm scared to touch anything.
Moves. I'm doing moves.
We can exclaim.
Oh, you know what?
Big set.
You know what we're tasting?
Exclamation.
What?
Stevia.
Stevia, that's what it is.
That's your name.
That
dude.
Is it. That's
it. It has stevia in it.
Stevia is strong.
In lieu of sugar, or it has
I'd rather have just sugar than sugar
and stevia.
Yeah.
They're trying to cut back on the sugar content by putting stevia.
But
stevia is so strong.
Stevia is strong, though. That's the problem.
It's,
it's
got a certain taste.
Yeah.
It's not bad, though. That's a good. That's a good.
It smells like we're at a. On the highway, and we pull off to the rest area. The bathroom.
Oh, my rest area is something. Let's talk about what we all got going on down there.
No, talk about those chips you're about to open.
I want to talk about what you got going on down there.
A little bit of...
Hey, we're in the middle of so to speak.
What are we going to do another one?
You want to do another one, or you want to save it?
It's up to you.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Tell me what we're talking about.
I need something else in my mouth.
Okay.
Sorry.
Inappropriate.
That's what Steve said.
I'm sorry.
Ooh, can I start that now?
This is why I'm not.
Can that's what Steve said be a thing?
Yeah.
That's what Steve says.
Pike's Peak Prickly Pear. Oh, this
Pike's
is going to be good.
Pike's Peak Prickly Pear.
Cane sugar. It's a small batch soda.
Small batch.
What do you know about this organization here, Steve?
I don't know. I'm a large batch guy, so. I know nothing about it. Is it? This is one of the sodas I picked up at that soda shop in.
Down in Georgia.
Marietta, Georgia. It was Rocket Fizz or
Rocky Mountain Soda out of Denver, Colorado.
Rocky Mountain Soda.
Great ingredient list: triple filtered carbonated water, evaporated cane sugar,
all
natural
the,
flavor, citric acid.
They're saying all the right things.
That's all the right things. I'll give you the
did
first.
Did you pop the top?
I did. We didn't show the bottle, but we. You can take a pull, show the bottle, and I'll take a pull.
Wow. That's not bad.
It's not auto-focusing.
It's not. I saw it turning.
Here we go. That's a cool...
What do you think? That's not overly... Okay. It's not overly pear.
I love
pear. I'll tell you what I don't like. Jelly Bellies? You ever had the pear one? The pear jelly belly reminds me of underarm sweat.
Pear.
But this is not underarm sweat. This is pretty good.
Is it better or worse?
This is good, but it has...
It's just like a sweet drink.
It's almost to the extreme of a flavored carbonated water. Very light on flavor.
Yeah, you're right. It's not very pear.
I like that, though.
Is that what's prickly about the pear?
Yeah. I've been drinking those St. Croix.
What do you think, cameraman?
I like it.
It's not void of everything.
No,
it's
not void of anything.
But in a good way.
It's not void of nothing, man. It's so full of stuff.
Double negative. I don't care what you have to say.
You're right. I was wrong.
Why don't you just end this, your sentence on a preposition?
I will go afar.
End your sentence on a preposition.
I will go afar if... I don't know what a preposition is.
Let's talk about something else.
Let's do some potato chips. You guys want to talk about potato chips?
Can I put this on the car baby face?
Nope.
What potato chip?
Are we listening to Radiohead?
It sounds like it, doesn't it? What potato chip are we gonna talk about?
I don't know. I just grabbed something. It looks like a Kettle Brand.
Okay. Now we've been saving these for a while.
Have we?
I am admittedly not a fan of garlic.
Okay. Well, then, but you still need to step up to the plate.
Right. And I will say that over the past few years, my aversion to garlic, which came on all of a sudden, has gone away slightly. So I'm not as worried about these Kettle Brand potato chips in roasted garlic flavor as I would normally be, because I've become a little bit lenient on the garlic flavor.
I like garlic as a starter.
I used to love it.
But I don't like it when it's
garlic.
Overly... what's it about this bag? Oh, you gotta do this.
When cameraman was here and cooking with garlic, it would make me sick across the house. I can't, it's not like that anymore. It's very weird.
There were times I would come in, did you eat garlic? I sleep in the yard.
He still ate some garlic. When I cook some stuff to put garlic in, he still eats it. Yeah, I'm telling though, I didn't try to put it over on you, did I? I never told you there was no garlic when there was garlic.
You never peanut sauced them.
These have a lot of garlic.
Mmm.
Mmm, they smell like garlic.
They're good though.
They're good.
I like that chip. Nice thick. Like a russet.
thick like a ripped ripple chip.
I like the way they taste.
Tim Heidecker, as long as they're ribbed chips. These are pretty good.
Kind of on the salty side.
I think what I like about them is when I go, do we hold these guys up?
What?
You hold them up?
I didn't show them the actual chip.
But if you go like chip to chip to chip to chip, I think they're really good. If you take a chip and you're like,
yeah,
nom, 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 and you're trying to do it, to absorb it.
Cannonball. 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 Come on. Cannonball.
It's a good
base. Cannonball.
It's a good
base. Steve, cannonball.
I think...
Cannonball.
Cannonball.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Caddyshack.
There's one person on earth knows.
I like them more than Tom.
Cannonball.
If I have too much time to think about how much garlic's in them, I become a little...
offended?
Concerned. But I don't know.
I must say, that's a pretty good chip, though.
Good chip. And you can very rarely go wrong with Kettle. They do it right most of the time.
They do have the most carcinogenic
of course they do.
Chip. That dark russet chip there's.
Russet, yeah,
really
right.
High in carcinogens.
All right, let's wrap this bitch up.
Wrap it up.
Thanks for joining us for this impossible
episode. Thanks for joining us for this impossible episode of Grown Man Record Night.
On a program that program should have never happened.
Should have never happened.
This show should have never happened.
Hey, you know, I will say this. My next gig is on May 25th.
Yeah.
It's on a Wednesday.
Oh.
Well, what it is, I'm singing the national anthem at the Dash.
Whoa, game. Get out of here.
Yeah. So.
National anthem singer.
My next gig. National
you have
anthem.
To wear something stupid.
Well.
You're eating garlic on purpose. Anyone?
I got to wear a big foam America.
Cape. You're singing in front of people.
I should
wear
sing
a cape.
With a cape. You're yeah. Right. I should wear a cape and a hat.
Over the top pretentious.
Send me some outlines of some costumes.
I'm pretty sure I just heard you say, I should sin in the cape.
Yeah.
I didn't say that. I didn't say that.
But that's what I
check
heard.
The Facebook.
You've been brave.
Keep up with us. We appreciate you. We'll catch you next week for a brand new episode about something else stupid that's going on and around this business.
I'll try not to do this again.
Yeah. Goddamn wild.
And you know,
I can't believe we pulled it off, man. Wow. Wow. You guys should be on your feet with a standing ovation right now.
You have no idea. Thanks for joining us, Grown Man Record Night. We'll catch you next time.
No idea. Let's listen to some Bowie.
Hey, kill them microphones over there.
Let's listen to some Bowie.